Hello everyone, this is Minion speaking. As you can see, well, this is not exactly one of my normal reviews here, because this is a real figure. This isn't Legend Creation anything, and everything's perfectly right. This is the actual legit figure, but we're not going to talk about Gogeta. We're talking about Gugeta, aka the Demoniacal Fit slash Possessed Horse custom head sculpt set that was made as kind of a companion piece to go along with the original figure. Now, the reason I say companion piece in this instance is because this particular head sculpt set actually covers a few gaps that the official release happened to have, namely that there weren't any official Super Saiyan hair colors, so basically the gold color was not actually present at all, although it did make an appearance in the movie, and the base head itself that was included with the original figure had all of a single face, which just cuts the smirking face on there, and nothing else to go with it. So what this particular headset provides is the Super Saiyan gold hair, along with a few extra faces to go with that, as well as an alternate version of the base head, which also has a few more faces kind of copying over what was used on the gold hair, or I should say the original blue haircut that the base figure had. Before we jump into the proper side-by-side, it's worth noting that the slightly metallic finish that they use for the Super Saiyan color here is a bit weird, because aside from maybe the Super Saiyan 3 Goku figure, no other one in the mainstream line, I think, actually does something like that, and it's something that kind of has been exclusive to the Super Saiyan God colors up to this point. But at least it kind of matches up for this particular set, so I guess that's kind of why they went with that. Now, as per our normal format, I'm going to try to keep the real stuff than the original release on the left here, and the custom headset, which I'm going to probably say bootleg as the short form, on the right. Looking at the general finish, as well as the general color choice for like the skin and the hair on the base heads, they're actually remarkably close, I'm going to be totally honest on that, and I'm actually quite happy with the quality of the Demoniacal Fit heads for the most part. Although, it's worth noting, as we're going to take a little lower look in a second here, as you might notice, the head sculpts on these two look very familiar, and that's because they're actually both based off the same original Gogeta blue head, which, when you actually look at the base head from the real figure, aren't exactly a perfect match. The bangs on the real head are actually slightly different from the ones on the front, which also means subsequently it's going to be a slightly different fit. Unfortunately, what that does mean is if for some reason you wanted to kind of take the smirking face off the real one and put it on the bootleg, or vice versa, switch the heads around, it's not actually going to fit properly as you want to, because they're not actually meant to fit with one another. However, going back to the general quality of the rest of the heads here and the rest of the faces, they're honestly really good. I'm actually quite happy with that. Decals are a nice touch on there. They're actually fairly good approximations of the original in there. And the color choices, everything feels fitting, like it would be able to fit properly on the main figure. Unfortunately, speaking of fit being the key word here, the alternate heads do have a bit of a fitting issue here and there. And that's namely because, unfortunately, much like all the other headsets that they've done up to this point, and this one being one of the earlier precursors, for that matter, the original casting, or the original figures, and these recasted versions, while they're high quality recasts, they are indeed recasts that are slightly smaller than what the real deals should mean. What does that mean? For a dramatic example right here, when I'm trying to put the real head on the fake one, as you can see, it's not a perfect fit. It's slightly different fitting on that one, because the real heads are slightly too large to fit on this smaller head. Not that you'll be really mixing them in a bit, but it's worth noting that this, unfortunately, will be kind of a common issue size-wise all the way around. And just for proof of concept, bootleg face on real head, it's not fitting at all because the way that the head is set up won't fit. But getting back to my main point, I should say, the heads, the way they're set up there, unfortunately, will have it so even the openings are slightly smaller than what they should be on the DF heads compared to the real deal. Which means, yep, we're going to have to do a little bit of modification in order to get this work. AKA, let's get the drill bit back out. In terms of how the modification goes, it pretty much is a pretty simple one. It's two steps. One, you take what in my case I believe was a 2.5mm drill bit, and basically just give it a few quick turns on both the Super Saiyan head as well as the base head in order to just expand the opening a little bit. You're just removing small slivers of material, really. And the second one, as you're planning on making the switches, dip the part in hot water for, I'm going to say, roughly a minute, in order to get it just soft enough in order to be more malleable and slip on there. Once you do that, honestly, everything is looking pretty nice on there. Even the slightly more metallic hair is actually a really good fit for the figure, I would say. And in terms of the faces, well, they're a bit hit or miss on mine, because just these things do vary in build quality from one to the other, it's constant QA issues with this particular company. But once you do manage to get the faces on there, yeah, everything is honestly looking very good, and I'm actually quite happy with how this looks. Hindsight being 2020, I might actually suggest the same thing for the faces when you're making those switch around. Probably dipping these things in hot water would make things a little easier to slip on and off the various heads, especially the yelling ones, which as you can see, I'm having a bit of issue on both the Super Saiyan as well as the general base head on this particular bit of footage. Which, speaking of which, this is what it looks like with the base head on there. As you can see, honestly, it's not exactly as fancy as the golden hair, but honestly, it's still a really nice fit on there and looks pretty good and serviceable. And as we try to struggle to get the yelling face on there, as you can see, I'm having a bit of the same issues I was having with the one on the golden hair. And that's just because, once again, the casting on this thing is slightly off kilter. I imagine heating the thing up a little more would have made this a slightly easier job. And kind of a general warning, the hair is really pointy on this cast, so just be careful as you're switching the heads on there. Don't push on them too hard for the ends. Now, the real question is, exactly who was this particular headset aimed at? For the original base look, it almost makes no real appearance in either of the movies that Gogeta appears in, so it's kind of a non-factor. And even the Super Saiyan hair, frankly, aside from maybe the Fusion Reborn look, where it was the prominent look at the time, it's only a transitionary thing in terms of the new movie, so I guess if you're picking this up, you either want it for a Fusion Board custom, or you just want every available option for your Gogeta figure. Which, in that case, all the more power to you. Otherwise, you might be able to skip on the set if I'm being totally honest. As for me, that's all for this particular year if I get this out in time. Thanks for watching, catch y'all later.